Disoriented, questioning perhaps where you are, who I am, how you got here. Get out of one? Or were you just starting to dream? Can't remember. It's funny how dreams work and create these big, vast, beautiful worlds that we may never return to. Take a look at you. Just want to have a little look here. I like to ascertain the needs of who call upon me based on their likeness, based on the little tiny clues I can inference from their posture, expressions, things that hide in the most obvious places. Just looking at your face, I think we'll have to do rearranging before I can weave you a beautiful, peaceful dream. Now, on your journey here, it looks as though you've gone through a bit of a dust storm. I say dust, but in reality it tends to be more something like stardust. Now, I think I have just the thing right here. Made of badger just like that. Tell me a little bit about your journey here, what you can remember. The whole thing is all a blur. Say that most of those that I see do not recall how they got here, just that they are. But sometimes I am surprised. Sometimes they come from a far-off land, one that I've never heard of, one with an elegant, lyrical name, with a language to match, melodic. Okay, you remember a little bit of your origin? Where you're from, where your home is. Mm-hmm. Stardust is stubborn stuff. It clings to the flesh. Sticks. But that's why comes in so handy. It's the stiffness of the bristles while still remaining soft. Picks it up, brushes it away. So tell me a little bit about your place of origin then. What the people are like. What the food is like. The music. I think I can hear that indeed. Noises and other stimuli bleed into the dreams. So that's what's known as a dream then. Sometimes those noises bleed into your dreams. It's just something to observe. Primarily these exposed parts that Stardust clings to. Down the neck. Does it tickle? I try to have a firm hand so that we can avoid that. dusting off the bones, the hollow there right below the neck. Good. If you wouldn't mind, I'd like to see your hands. Stardust is not harmful per se, but it is a little gritty. It's a touch annoying. Fanciful things linger in your imagination. Scenarios that cling to your daydreams. Tell me a bit about that. I do my best to include what one asks for, so long as it coincides with a general premise. I like things to make sense. There are so many dreams that make absolutely no sense, and I like to have a bit of order amongst the chaos. I think we'll have to do a touch of rearranging. Now, what I'm just going to be doing is I tend to just pinch and work with the little tendrils of thoughts, put them back. It's a precursor to weaving the dream. Gently rearranging them. Just like that. I may pull thoughts that serve no purpose and drop them into snaps, tossing that into the flame. I just circle this bit, pull that with ease, and that comes away. Good. And if I just come in and just rearrange this a bit, thoughts, feelings, that they are more conducive to sleeping peacefully, pulling, dropping, pulling. Gently rearranging them. Just a couple last little bits that I just need to pull away and discard. Last one, I think. Do I just pull? Now, the fun part begins. This is where we do a little dream writing. Now, I ask that you sit very still. These spells, if you will, these incantations, are very sensitive to any sort of mistranslation. If I mess up even just the slightest dash, dot, mark, who knows what your dream could end up being. Now, I'm going to take this point. I'm just going to draw still. very focused. Very focused. That. You write the blueprints of your beautiful, perfect dream. Let us weave this dream, shall we? Now, I'm going to be counting down as I go, and I want you to just listen to the soft words as we count you down, and as I flesh out your dream, your peaceful, Sixty-five, sixty-four, Trees bow overhead as the wind whistles past you. A warm breeze wrapping around your body. Your feet are planted on the ground, connected to the earth and rooted. And at ease as the sun peeks through the verdant canopy. This forest whispers safety and tranquility, allowing you to feel calm and present. Time is not a problem here. There are no deadlines, no alarms, no pressing concerns. You are one with the forest, and the forest is one with you. You can allow your thoughts lazily by and just enjoy the landscape around you. You take a seat on the forest floor, crinkling leaves crunching underneath your body. There are so many beautiful specimens in this forest. Aromatic bergamot with its lavender flowers flourishes under the sunny break in the trees, its scent reminding you of crushed mint and oregano. Lance-leafed milkweed pops underneath, soft pink clusters of flowers beckoning butterflies to stop and eat. The elderberry bushes dotting the land have produced their season's fruit, black glistening berries. Place is sacred, peaceful. This place is for you to relax. Take a deep breath, inhale it all. The must of the soil and decaying wood. Inhale the freshness of the green foliage. Exhale fully. Inhale the light heat of the sun rays poking through. In this forest, your body can feel at ease. Take a moment to scan down your body. You can take note of the tension in your body, whether it's your feet or neck or back, and allow the muscles to soften. There is no need to tighten your muscles. You are safe and able to relax in this space. Your feet are light and warm. Your legs are relaxed, the muscles loose. Your abdomen rises softly with the rhythm of your breath. Your arms are like noodles, free to move in any direction. You can roll your shoulders back, allowing them to sink down. Your neck is able to straighten without being stiff, balancing your head without putting unnecessary stress on either. Birds chirp in the distance, a bright song filling the overhead. The squirrels jump from branch to branch, chasing each other. If you are quiet, you may see a doe with her babies cross the threshold, her tawny coat shining in the daylight. Take a moment. Watch the animals as they pass. The animals of this forest enjoy the simple pleasures of eating from the plentiful resources and playing with the members of their respective communities. An owl utters its "Ha-hoo!" call. The morning doves coo on the ground. The foxes and raccoons slumber in their secret hideaways, waiting for night to fall. The forest is full of lively conversations if you take the time. So many sights and sounds and smells, but you have not yet discovered the sense of taste in these woods. Look to the side of the minty bergamot and the towering elderberries, and tucked in between, you find a sprawling bush of pale yellow honeysuckles. If you were to reach out and pluck one of the flowers to bring it to your mouth, you could taste the subtle honey flavor for which they are named after. A light, delicate taste dances on the edge of your tongue. Ducking down underneath the branches, you can find the last remaining clovers reaching for the sun. Their tops are an ombre of fuchsia to pink flowers. The drop-shaped heads yield small cylindrical petals. Each tubular petal tastes of white cane sugar, like you dipped your finger into the paper bag and dropped the tiny crystals. The best the forest has to offer, however, is what is colloquially called black caps. Wild raspberry vines arch several feet above the ground. One needs to mind the thorns that dot the stem, but on the ends of the branches grow clusters of succulent These fruit are so dark and rich with purple juices that they are colored a deep midnight black. The berry melts in your mouth, coating your tongue in fragrant and flavorful juice. The wild black caps are unrivaled in terms of their red cousins, the flavor unmatched by any other fruit. Allow yourself to inhale all of the sweetness the woods have to offer. Breathe in the delicate scent of the honeysuckle blossoms. Breathe out all the way. Breathe in sugary petals of the wild pink clovers. Breathe out fully. Breathe in the tangy, exotic scent of the black caps on the vine. Time. Bask in the beauty of the forest. Bask in its silence, its scents, its warm and gentle breeze. Your mind and body are able to rest in this tranquil forest, and when you awake, you will feel well rested and alert, ready for your day. Allow yourself to rest. Allow yourself